even though I'm mostly from Tennessee, which is landlocked. As a kid, my grandparents owned a little cottage on the Jersey Shore, and I used to spend about 6 weeks every summer there on the shore. So maybe that's what got me into the business. Listening to the waves at night. I'd be happy to give you the story. It's a good one. But this was back in the late 1980s. Most of the work that had been done in underwater acoustic surveillance had been done classified within the military. We hooked in the Navy's system in August of 91. So we had a laboratory that was collecting continuously the signals from the Navy's underwater listening systems and having these blue and red colorful spectrograms streaming by on the screens and routinely marking into a logbook, here's a whale, here's this, here's that. But there were occasionally, rarely, but occasionally there were sounds that we just could not identify. I remember one sound in particular. We called it Bloop because when you listen to it, it sounds like Bloop. It's captivating because we don't know what it was and it doesn't recur. It lasted about a minute. It's heard simultaneously on hydrophones that are thousands of kilometers apart. This is heard 5,000 miles away, so it's very, very loud. And, of course, it's very, very low. A long, rising sound. So it's... within 10, 15 minutes, you'd have everybody in the whole team, which is about a dozen of us, all gathered around trying to think of explanations and trying to think of ways that we could enhance it. So it was like a detective work. I actually took it to the very classified innards of the United States Navy intelligence people to see if I thought it might actually be some sort of a military system that I wasn't familiar with, and I took it to them, and they said, nope, it's not ours. It didn't seem to be man-made. We considered every possibility. And we, including animal origin, other things in nature that make that sound are blue whales for whatever reason. But very quickly we understood that when we looked at the volume of the sound, certainly it is much louder than the loudest animal sound that we are aware of, many more times more powerful than a blue whale, and of course they're the largest animal ever, so to produce a low frequency you have to be something big. You can get off into some really far-fetched things that go outside of the scientific realm, and somehow the Bloop seemed to have captured the imagination of everyone. Someone wants to say, well, there's a gigantic monster out there we don't know about, then I won't join that conversation. But when you have sounds that you don't know what the phenomenon is, Maybe it's like visually seeing something through the fog. Being, it's just an interesting observation that we made that we really can't figure out. Is it bothersome that what we put up as a scientific thing has sort of been carried beyond scientific rigor? Yes and no. It doesn't bother me. I'm glad there's still some mysteries out there.